Full House. And not the TV show, I don't think. Where are the Olsen twins? A friend of Dan's was coming to visit. Something over there. Anybody in here? I hear somebody walking around. Whoa! Okay. Oops. I was stuck on the chair. Is there something right here? Yes, there is. Guy, probably not expecting to hear from you. From me, were you? You know I'm all about surprises. Look, we're going to head up the coast next weekend. We're doing the drive from LA to Seattle. I have an interview up there on Tuesday, and Kelly has a friend who's going to introduce her to some casting people from Vancouver. Can we crash at your place on the way up? We should be pulling through next Friday. I was thinking we could use it as an excuse to jam on our books. I want to see your new stuff, and I have a draft I want you to take a look at. I am way beyond knowing what's good and or good or not with my work, so I could really use your advice. And you know I'll give it to you straight about your new book. Is there a title yet? Could be an impromptu writer's workshop, I guess. Anyway, I guess it'd be fun. Let me know. T. T. I hear Dan working. I can't get in the light. Okay, there we go. I was struggling to get in the light there. Anything in the kitchen? Ooh, there's a picture on the refrigerator. Okay. Tommy and a friend? Someone from camp, maybe? Maybe. Let's go see what Linda is doing. Is there anything in this bathroom? Nope, nothing in the bathroom. Let's look at this picture. What's this source? Check sofa, call Chamber of Commerce, hotels in town. Double check T&K trip when Dan gets back. Sounds close. Oh, here we go. I never know who to go first. Sometimes it doesn't make sense.
I'm checking to see if this is a folder.
I thought Tommy was sleeping with us.
Okay. Something upstairs, it sounds like. Oh, there she is. Go to the light. To the light. I can't get in that light. Can't get in that light.
Tommy's asleep now, and I just tried for the last time to talk Dan into taking better care of himself, but he didn't listen. He went on about how he was still young, about how he just didn't have the time for a hobby like jogging, as if caring about your health is a hobby. It's so frustrating, but you can't make people do something if they don't want to. I just hope he has a change of heart someday and realizes that he won't be young forever. You can't take good health for granted.
No, you can't. Okay, that's all of Linda's memories. Oops, wrong button. E to exit. There we go. Note. I talked to Davy's parents, and they're okay with him sleeping over. They said they'd take care of Tommy some weekend in return. I know the timing isn't great, but maybe we can work something out. Let's talk when you get up. Lynn. So Tommy has a friend coming over. That's who Tommy's visitor was.
Good news! Mom called today with a change of plans. They made better time on the first leg of the trip than they expected, and they're coming to visit. Bad news, they want to come this weekend. Did Dan tell Tynan they could stay here for sure, or is that still up in the air? I'll ask after dinner. She sounded cheerful enough on the phone, though I can't help wondering if they took this trip because they hit another rough patch. I hope not. I hope they just want to see Tommy and have a classic Mears family feast, though maybe seeing how they've ended up will be good perspective for Dan and me. Speaking of which, Dad better not get nosy. I've told him a million times that my marriage is not his business. Maybe I'll try the thing Christine told me. When someone asks you something private, just say, "Why do you ask?" Put it back on them and see if they've actually got a reason to get into your business. Yeah, I've got to remember to try that. We'll see how he answers that one.
So that definitely is going to be... Ooh. Didn't want to bother you while you were working, but didn't want to forget again. Been meaning to ask, have you found any ponds on your hike? Creeks? No rush, just curious. Okay, I can get him. She is stuffed. There we go. That proved to be more difficult than probably what it should have been. In the bedroom. Sounds like there might be something. Oh, there.
You can sleep with us.
That's what we're talking about, Tommy, maybe?
What about Tommy?
What about Tommy?
What about Tommy?
He can sleep with us.
He can sleep with us.
So I never know who to grab first there. There. Go out of the light. Okay, there we go.
Haven't had a drink on a weeknight in 2 weeks. Came up with a new slogan. Write sober, rewrite sober, rewrite sober. Hemingway, it's not, but it's good to smooth things over with Linda and Tommy a bit. Gotta admit, I don't miss hangovers, but still, I do sometimes miss sitting down with a drink and a crazy idea.
All up dance, now we have to get Tommy. Where did Tommy go? Another picture on the wall. Let's see what Tommy TV Westerns on Saturday. It's not in his room. In here? Sounds like something's in here. Uh-huh. He's always just around drawing. There's that picture of him and Gabe Kaplan. There's one of his. Kitchen. Aha. Who do we go to? Mom or him? That's Tommy.
Can Davey sleep over?
Aha.
Let me call his mom.
Ah, I got it. Right that time for a change. And then... Must be him and Tommy. Tommy's for the sleepover. Wish the ugly sweater Mom and Dad gave me so they can see me wearing it. I'll wash that ugly sweater. Wish. Wash that ugly sweater. Okay. Or what does... Check those fishing poles. Maybe we could find a pond. Alright. And Tommy. Blue sheets to make a sofa fort. Blue sheets. Fishing poles. Or an ugly sweater. Well, there's are some fishing poles. If we want to do... Dan. Oh, there's something here. Honey, I'm sorry it's been so long since my last letter, but we've been all over the place. We've gotten settled. Have you gotten settled into the big house yet? I hope getting away from everything has been a help for you and Dan. I'm writing because, speaking of getting away, your father and I are going to take a road trip. I found some good AARP deals, and with your father only working part-time, it wasn't very hard to arrange time off. It's been too long since our last trip. I've always enjoyed changes of scenery, and as you're hopefully learning, it can be just the thing a marriage needs. Lord knows it's helped us. The trip won't take us close enough to the shore to come visit, I'm sorry to say, and if you write back, we'll be gone before your letter arrives. We'll call if one of our motels has long distance, but if we don't get a chance to call, send my love to Dan and Thomas. You know your father and I want the best for you all. Love, Mom. So they weren't going to come, but they ended up. I don't want to keep rotating. Let's get Tommy. Let's help. I know we just did Tommy. There's sheets. Let's do Tommy. Again. It's nighttime and we can go around the house fairly free, not having to worry about anybody. Yes, we know. Oops. We had our compromises. The picture's already gone. Oop, there's a book. The Diary of Claire Bradford, September 5th, 1961. Maybe getting my thoughts down on paper will help. Make a list. That's what Mom always taught me. So, dear diary, here are all the wonderful things about Roger. He's very handsome. He'll be working as a lawyer at his father's firm, though the job is no gift. He worked so hard in college. He thought he might be the only person on earth who loves music as much as me. He especially loves the songs I write him. His family has money, which of course shouldn't matter, but it's nice to feel secure. Who wouldn't want to marry someone like that? Claire Bradford. Must have been the previous occupant of the house. Oh, she's changed paintings. It's no more of the bird in the cage. Oh, there's the bird in the cage. She finished. The bird in the cage. Maybe she's no longer trapped in a cage. The door was open. Okay. Okay, check the bedroom. Oh, here we go. Here's another book. The Diary of Claire Bradford, September 6th, the next day, 1961. I don't know why, but I feel like I can really get my thoughts together here. That's why this entry isn't going to be very fun, but fair is fair. I've already waited a day, and there's no use delaying it any longer. Here's the not-so-wonderful things about Roger. He can be self-absorbed, especially when he's working on something. No one will ever accuse him of having a great sense of humor. He's very predictable. Sometimes that makes me feel secure, other times it makes me feel so bored. I wonder if maybe he spends too much time chasing his father and not enough time being his own man. There. I know I feel rotten. I do love him very much. Everyone has their flaws. And are his so bad? Very intriguing. All right, let's go tell Dan. Why you should do this? What are they doing with the couch? Looks like they're tipping it over. Looking for loose change, maybe? Oh, I bet they're getting his sleepover ready. Yeah, let's see. Dan knew how important it was for Tommy to play with friends his age, so he grabbed the sheets and gave Tommy a few tips on the finer points of structural engineering and sofa fort construction. When Davy came over, the two boys stayed up and watched TV and eating ice cream far past their bedtimes, laughing and playing until they ran out of steam and passed out in the fort. What's he doing? Oh, waving? No? I'm not sure what he's doing. I guess we'll see. Is it goes back a little bit more. Dan hating missing a chance to get feedback on his book, and he found the company distracting. He tried to work through the commotion, but never got into a rhythm. He couldn't even focus long enough to do a small corrections, so instead he accepted the role of selfless host and spent the weekend running errands, not working. Thought she'd be upset about not wearing a hideous sweater her parents gave her for last Christmas, but she found herself eyeing it sadly. When her mother called and Linda had to break the news, she heard a hitch in her mother's voice that worried her. She tried to find out if her parents were okay, but her mother made a comment about how much of long distance call cost, and cut the conversation short. I never even did see that sweater. Wonder where it was hiding at anyway.